Den 8 meter høye muren mellom Vestbredden og Israel hindrer folk og lokalsamfunn å ha normal kontakt med hverandre. Den ydmyker mennesker og skaper en kultur av adskillelse, fremmedgjøring og frykt. Det internasjonale samfunn og en god del israelere og alle palestinerne mener at muren må bort. Barrieren snor seg 650 kilometer gjennom terrenget, ofte langt inne på okkupert område, og skiller ikke bare israelere fra palestinere, men også palestinere fra palestinere. Mange har sine jordbruksland på andre siden av denne separasjonsbarrieren. Den ble påbegynt i 2004 med et uttalt formål å hindre selvmordsbombere å trenge inn i Israel. Det er legitimt å få dekket sikkerhetsbehov på alle sider av denne konflikten. Men sikkerhet kan bli ivaretatt gjennom alternative metoder som kan stanse terror. I dag oppleves muren som en kollektiv avstraffelse av svært mange uskyldige.
Before the wall, we didn't feel so much the pressure of occupation. But in 2004, this wall was built. And when they started to do, we didn't recognize that it would be isolated wall. And it is something politics. We thought that some construction around. And whenever we ask the officers or those who work, they didn't give us any answer. We felt that we are like animals in a cage. And we start crying, all the family, the old ones and the little ones, because we were isolated from our neighbors, from our relatives, and from our land where there were a lot of olives, and we live from this harvest. It is our insurance, it's our secure from the grandpas to the grandchildren, because sometimes we don't have jobs, we don't have enough opportunity to work or to travel. So the first year we were hoping that it is only for a short time. But it is lasting now for 10 years.
I'm doing this as an Israeli for my own society. I think the occupation corrupts the Israeli society, harms the soldiers who have to do the dirty work, so to say. And it affects our whole political and social scene. Of course, you can see it more when you look at the Palestinians, because there you see it on an everyday life and on an everyday basis. You can see it at the checkpoints, and you can see it on the roads, and you can see it after when they want to go to work, they need permits for everything. There are 101 different kinds of permits that the Palestinian might be needing in order to go to work in Israel, I have to admit, but he also might have to go to hospitals, and some of the Palestinian major hospitals, you don't have a hospital at every little village. One of the major hospitals, Palestinian hospitals, is in East Jerusalem. Mm. And in order to get there, you need a permit. Now we are at Ramadan. Today is Wednesday. In 2 days it will be Friday again. Suddenly all these dangerous people can cross without any papers, in their hundreds, in their thousands. So there is something illogical there, because if they're so dangerous, how come they stop being dangerous on a Friday of the Ramadan, 4 weeks or 5 weeks during the year, and they're so dangerous all along the year? So when we look at all this and we look at Palestinians' lives, we always have to ask ourselves these questions. I think when we look at it, we should always look at it from two sides. It's not a one-sided story. From the other point of view, there are not two equals here. There is an occupier and an occupied people. They are not on an even basis. And there's someone who has the power and someone who has very little power. So when you look at this, it's a very complicated and very difficult to explain situation. Mm. Because there are a lot of emotions involved, And I think the Israelis are very good at putting the whole picture into a frightening Israeli population.
Every Friday we go around the wall praying to God to give us peace. And when we pray for both sides, for the Palestinians and for the Israelis. Because as Israelis, they are good people, as public, as mothers, sisters, families. But with this the politicians that we don't understand, and like me, we are not so active in politics, we don't feel secure, we don't feel peace, we always have anxious and fear and disturbed. So hoping one day what happened in Berlin, that the wall came down after 35 years, so hopefully it will not last more, and we would like to replace it with bridges and not with isolation. The bridge, we come together, yeah, and we can make use of our life.
I think that both sides are paying a heavy price. Every year there is some kind of a war, and people die, and as far as I'm concerned, I don't look at how many people died on the other side and how many people died on this side. Death is death is death. Doesn't matter if you are a Palestinian, if you are a dead child. I don't care if it's an Israeli child or a Palestinian child. They are all children. They shouldn't be involved. And of course, I think that the hatred is getting deeper and deeper. Racism is unbelievable. And the prices are very high. And time lost is something that people feel. 10 minutes at a checkpoint, when you don't know what's going to happen to you, am I going to cross or am I not going to cross? Are they going to be violent or not? There is not much physical violence at the checkpoints, but there is a lot of verbal violence and behavioral violence every day. Not for all people, but for most people, every day, especially those that pass. Humiliation all the time. And the time loss. The time loss has a tremendous effect, because in order to be on time at work, you have to leave earlier and earlier and earlier. You come back later and later and later. It affects your family life. It affects the way the children look at you. Why aren't you fighting it? Children are always have more stamina. And you have no life.
Brudd på menneskerettighetene langs separasjonsbarrieren er bekreftet av den internasjonale domstolen i Haag i 2004. Den har sagt at muren må demonteres. De praktiske følgene av at muren er bygget er godt dokumentert. Den har bidratt til å forsterke fiendebildene på begge sider av skillet. De som må passere barrieren opplever en daglig prøvelse når de skal på jobb, til sykehus eller besøke slektinger og helligdommer som ligger på den andre siden. Muren illustrerer maktforholdet som rår mellom Israel og en undertrykt befolkning. Mange israelske røster, blant dem rabbinere for fred, hevder at barrieren underminerer sentrale jødiske moralske idealer om å fremme fred og forsoning. Konsekvensene av muren ødelegger ikke bare for palestinernes, men også for Israels fremtid ved å undergrave mulighetene for fredelig sameksistens. Kirkene i Norge kan ikke stille seg likegyldig til en separasjonsbarriere som krenker menneskerettighetene massivt hver eneste dag. Den verdensvide kirke må forsterke sin støtte til fredskreftene som vil bygge broer mellom folkegrupper og religioner i området og motvirke at hatet forsterker uforsonligheten. Derfor arrangerer kirker og organisasjoner i Norge og mange steder i verden Kirkeuka for fred i Israel og Palestina, Den skal bidra til å peke på at det er sterkt behov for endringer nå.